This week on the Storycraft Society, we're doing Quickcraft number 3, where we're making these awesome modular fences. Let's go. Welcome back to the Storycraft Society, and here we are for another week of our series called Quickcraft, actually Quickcraft number 3, where we make a piece of Dungeons and Dragons or wargaming terrain that only takes us one afternoon to do it. Now this episode is a little different than the first two. It'll only take you an afternoon to make one or two, maybe even four of these little pieces. It'll definitely take you longer to make a full set, but the individual pieces themselves are very easy to make and you can knock out a set pretty fast. So the story behind this particular episode is that actually a few months ago I made this little paddock here, and it's one of my favorite pieces that I've ever made. I just really liked the way that it turned out and how it looked, how it felt. It felt very real, and I'm very happy with that particular piece. So the problem that I had was that all I could ever use that piece for was as a paddock, and I wanted a modular set of the exact same fences that I could use to be a road, to, you know, border off someone's property, to make little farm fields, whatever. So I knew that I wanted to do it, and finally I said, you know what, this week, that's what we're doing. I want a set to add to my collection, and that's what we're doing. So this is a very easy piece, one that I'm very excited to show you all how to do. So let's just dive into crafting. Let's do it.
All right, so to start this project off, I'm gonna be pulling out my heavyweight chipboard, and then I'm gonna be cutting little squares out of it like this. This is what's gonna end up being the feet for the fences. You know, a fence post will come up here and a fence post will come up here, and then the two rungs will go across like that. Once we have that done, then we're gonna be pulling out our Ulfa knife, and we're gonna start cutting that into a natural looking circle, because this is gonna end up being our dirt that's piled around the outside edges of our fence post. The way that I do that is I cut it down into a hexagon shape, and then I go to the points and I kind of cut off the points. That gets me down to a circle shape quicker than trying to do some weird curved cut with my blade. When that's done, we're gonna take and start shaving off the outside edge. So now we have our little pile of dirt shape. With that done, we're gonna just take a sanding block real quick. You can do this with sandpaper, you could do it with a nail file, but I'm just gonna quick hit kind of across all those edges. A little bit more natural, less kind of jagged edges. And there we have one of our feet. You're gonna wanna make two of these per fence that you make, because you'll need one on this side and one on this side. Once we have that done, the next thing we need to do is make the fence posts that come straight up. So what I'm gonna be using to make those is these mini wood sticks that I got from Walmart. But the cool thing is they're actually the exact same thing as you would get on a matchstick. So you could easily just use a matchstick for this. It would work just as well. But I'm going to take and cut these to being just a little less than 1 inch. And again, you're gonna need two of these per fence section that you do. So with those cut, you're gonna have your base, you're gonna have your fence post that goes up, and then you also need the rungs that go across. So for those, I'm gonna be using these skinny sticks that I also got from Walmart. So you're gonna take one of those and then very carefully take your Ulfa knife and just cut right down the center. The first cut that you make, you're just gonna barely make a mark in the stick. And then every cut after that, you can apply a little bit more pressure and a little bit more pressure until finally the piece splits. This is going to get you the best cut where it doesn't just splinter off into a bunch of little pieces. But when you get them cut, they're going to look just like this. And then now what I found is the perfect length for me for these fence boards is just by cutting these exactly in half, which is just 1/8 of an inch less than 3 inches. And so now I have two of those that can go onto my fence boards like that, and that's gonna be how we're gonna make our fence up. Once you have that done, you're gonna take and make sure to sand all of the edges, because what that does is it makes them look like rough-hewn wood. This step shouldn't take you too long, but the more sanding you do on the edges and cutting off all those like really sharp angular things will make the fence look more worn and more, you know, ready to go onto a old fence line.
All right, so now that we have all of our little wood pieces cut, we are now ready to get onto texturing and painting them. So the first step is gonna be texturing them to make them look like wood. And I know that that sounds kind of crazy to think, oh, well, a piece of craft stick is wood, so it should look like wood. But what we need is a more exaggerated wood grain. So the way that I do that is actually a trick that I got from Neil over at Real Terrain Hobbies, which is you take a set of pliers and the
tight part where the teeth are, you can take that and go down your craft stick, applying pressure the whole way down in small little clamped sections. And that puts this grain into the wood that really shows up well once you actually get to painting it. And dry brushing it just makes this explode and look so good from a distance. Once you've got that done, then it's time to move on to painting. So for painting, we're gonna start with a medium brown that we water down almost to being a wash. You'll know you're at a good mixture of water to paint if the brown still coats the outside of your craft stick, but the water immediately soaks down into it fast. And then you're just gonna take and cover all your pieces in this medium brown wash. After you've got that done, you're gonna wanna let those dry. This is important. You don't want them to be still a little soggy when you move on to the next step. You're gonna lose some crispiness and detail that way. But when that's dry, then you're gonna move onto a dry brushing of gray all over the piece. That dry brushing of gray doesn't have to be anything spectacular, just a quick whoop, 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 and you're over the whole thing. Then we're gonna move on to a dry brush of a khaki. That khaki is gonna really start to bring some of those highlights up. But the final step is a really light dry brushing. And when I say light, I mean go at this very sparingly. You can even maybe just take it down from the top if you want, but with an off-white. And that's really gonna bring all the edges and the detail right to the forefront on these pieces. So once you get them all painted up and textured like that, then it's time to move on to the bases. So let's get over to that. So now that we have all our fence pieces painted up and ready to go, it's time to start assembling these things. So we're gonna start by doing our fence posts. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take our little bases that we made and we're gonna drill a hole in the center of those. Now, you could use an X-Acto knife for this step. You just have to be really careful and just go slow and just kind of twist the blade until you get the right size hole. The reason I like using the drill is obviously it's just faster and you can get a little bit cleaner of a cut. So once you get all of the holes drilled in the center of those pieces, you're gonna take them back over the top and bottom one more time on your sandpaper just to make sure that you get off any kind of rough edges, and then we can start assembling these things. So to start assembling these pieces, we're gonna take our super glue and we are gonna put a dot of that onto the base of one of our fence posts here. And this is definitely one of those situations where less is probably more. That probably was a little too much. And then we're gonna take and push that down into the hole as far down as we can get it down to the table and then let that dry. And now we're just gonna do that three more times. So for the next step, I was trying to remember if I've covered this in a previous video or not, and I just couldn't remember. So I'm gonna cover it now because this is honestly one of my favorite techniques in all of crafting. So there's this miracle thing that happens. Sounds like I'm being sarcastic. I'm not. If you take super glue and put it onto a surface and then take and pour baking soda onto it, the baking soda, for whatever reason, causes the super glue to dry instantly and it gets this kind of rough, bumpy, like maybe almost sandy texture. This is such a useful thing for when you're doing something like little tiny small bases like this that you don't have to wait for PVA and sand to dry. You can get that same look and texture instantly with super glue. So this next step is going to be but one other thing. And so what we're gonna do is actually take our super glue and we're going to put it all around the base of our fence post and then down and cover the entire base. So what that's gonna do is it's gonna give us a stronger point where the fence post is connected to the base, just a little bit of extra strength, never a bad thing. And two, when we dump our baking soda all over it, it's gonna make it look like piled up dirt instead of just looking like a sanded smooth base. So now that we have our fence posts done, it's time to assemble our fences, which actually is really easy to do. So what we're gonna do is take one of our fence posts, we're gonna get some super glue, and you're just going to put a dot of super glue where you want your fence board to set. Then you're gonna take your fence board and put that in place. Let that sit there for a second to dry. While that one's drying, you can put your next one in. Once those are dry enough to hold, now the trick is instead of putting the glue on the fence post, you're gonna put it on the fence board. You're just gonna put a dot where you want it. Flip this bad boy up, set it in place, wait a second for it to dry, and there you have a section of fence. Making progress.
So the next step is gonna be what takes these fences and makes them go from looking okay to looking really good. We're gonna take some pretty fine string. It looks really good for scale rope. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to get our fingers covered in PVA glue and then twist it down into the string. We then wrap around the fence posts in the joints. It sticks to the fence posts, which is great. And then it allows us to just kind of tuck the ends in to give a really convincing tied up fence board look. A really, really easy step that's gonna make these things go from like a 5 to like an 8 really quick. So all we needed to do to finish these pieces up was to put Black Magic Craft base coat on the bases and get them painted up with a dark brown to a medium brown to a light brown in a dry brush. And that makes it look like the piled up dirt around the bottom of our fence posts. And these pieces are done. As you can see, I'm really excited with the way that this whole entire set turned out. This cool frontier farm setting is just so awesome. And these kind of roped up farm fences are such a cool way to make that happen and have that visual aesthetic on my table. And there we have another episode of Quickcraft all wrapped up. I am so excited about this series. It's definitely something that I'm going to continue to do in the future. If you like this content, definitely leave me a like down below. In the comments section below, I would love to hear from you all. What are some examples of cool ideas for Quickcrafts that you would like to see in this series in the future? There are just so many options of something that you can make quick and easy to just drop on the table. And if there's any good suggestions out there, I would love to have them and potentially use them in a video coming up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, definitely do that. It goes a long way to helping the channel, and obviously ring the notification bell if you want to know when our videos go live every week, which is Thursday Eastern Standard Time at noon. But that's it. That's all I got for this week. Boy howdy. Farm fences. Finally got them. Let's go. We'll see y'all next week.